Hi friends, welcome back to Credible. Today we'll do this torque simulation in SolidWorks, and actually we'll do three simulations, and in the end we'll compare these simulations. And first of all, I'll apply load, let's suppose here, and in the second simulation I'll apply load or torque on this whole shaft, and in the third simulation I'll apply load or torque on this side only, right? And in all simulations we have same material, same mesh density, same torque, that is 100 newton, and same constraints or fixtures, and that is I'll constrain my body from here, and in the end we'll compare our results so that we can find the changes in the rod. First of all, I have to make this geometry, and let's go to new and select part and select OK, and now we are in SolidWorks interface. It will take some time, and so we are in SolidWorks interface. First of all, I'll change my background to, let's say, plain white, and my units are already in MMGS. Let's go to front plane, select sketch, and we'll sketch first of all our shaft, and the diameter was 50 mm, so change it to 50, and the length of the shaft was 400 from the mid plane, so I'll change this blind option to mid plane and select OK. So the basic shaft is done, and now I'll make a rectangle here. Go to sketch, go to select this face, and we will select the center rectangle, and we'll make a center rectangle of let's say 100 by 100. So we'll make 100, and just select this line, press shift, and this line, and select make equal relation, right? Now I'll go to features, I'll go to extruded boss, and the thickness of this fixture or this fixture side or this plate will be 50 mm, and select OK. So the basic geometry is done, and now I have to make a central axis, because when I'll do simulation it will require a reference. So I'm already in features mode. Go to curves, in fact go to reference geometry, and go to axis, and select this shaft, the outer dia, and it has created an axis, and select OK. And for the third simulation, as you can see from here, go to SolidWorks again. In the third simulation, I have applied load on this side, so I need split line command so that I can divide my shaft into let's say two pieces. And let's go to SolidWorks again, and let's select top plane, select sketch, and select normal to view. And I have to make a line, and the line will be 100 mm from this. In fact, let's drag this line. I think it's okay. No need to give dimension, because I only need to separate some part, right? And go to split line, select this sketch, select this shaft, and select OK. And it has divided my shaft into two pieces, as you can see, right? Next I'll go to simulation studies. For this I'll go to add-ins, and make sure to check this box, right? SolidWorks simulation. and press OK. So now I'll go to simulation and I'll go to new study, select new study, and you can rename your simulation, let's say talk simulation, and we'll select this. Okay, right. So we are in simulation mode. I think it's better to hide this shadow because it is creating some disturbance, right? First of all, I have to apply a material. So let's go to part and let's go to apply edit material, and let's say I'll apply a material, carbon steel. You can apply any material, because in any simulation you need to apply material, right? And I'll use this material in all simulation studies, right? So I'll select carbon steel and select OK, right? So we have selected carbon steel, as you can see from here. And next, here I'll not use this option, because when you have multiple parts or you have assemblies, you usually use this option. But here I have a single body, so I'll not use connections. Go to features, in fact go to fixture, and go to fixture geometry, and I'll fix my geometry from this side, right? From this side, this side, this face, and let's say this face, and on the bottom face as well, right? So I have constrained my geometry, and I'll use this constrained geometry in all my simulations, right? I have constrained my geometry, so select OK. Next, I have to apply load, so go to external load, and in this simulation I'll use torque, right? In the previous simulation, in the previous tutorial, I have used force simulation. That is a simple, I have made a simple cantilever beam and I apply force on that cantilever beam. So here I'm using torque, so select torque. And for this, let's say I have to apply torque on this face, right? And I need an axis for reference. That's why I make this axis when I was modeling the geometry. And we have to change this to, let's say, 100 mm, 100 Newton meter, not 100 mm, and select OK. So our simulation study almost done. Next, I'll go to mesh, and here we have two options: create mesh and mesh and run. I usually use mesh and run, but for this tutorial I make let's say create mesh, and here it is showing mesh density, so I think it's fine to me, and select OK. So mesh has been created. As you can see, our body is divided into small pieces or small meshes. Next, I'll go to run this study, and it will take some time. Here you can see that our geometry is distorted. So let's go to SolidWorks and scaled my results. Let's say I'll go to stress. You can go to any result, let's say displacement or strain. Let's go to stress and edit definition, and here you can see that our scale is changed to some 1700, right? So I need a true scale, select true scale, and select OK. So here is the actual result, right? And this is our first simulation, and let's suppose I'll go to stress again, and I'll go to chart options, and here make sure to check this box, show minimum annotation and show maximum annotation, right? So here is the minimum stress, as you can see, and here is the maximum stress. And in fact, as you can see from this color contour as well, right, on this red side maximum and on this blue side minimum, right, as you can see from this scale as well. So this is our first simulation. Next, let's say I'll go to create new simulation study, and you can rename it, but here I'll not rename it. Select OK, and here I'll go to part, and I'll apply same material, carbon steel. Select apply, and go to fixture, fixed geometry, this face, and this face, and on this face as well, right? Select OK, and next, external load, go to torque, and this time I'll apply torque on this whole shaft, right? So let's go to this axis, and I'll apply, just make sure to press shift, right, just delete this and select this axis, right? So I'll apply torque or external force on this whole shaft in the second simulation, right? And select OK. In fact, make sure to change this to 100 Newton meter, because I'll apply same torque on all simulations. Select OK, and this time I'll go to mesh and run, right? Again, SolidWorks has distorted my result. It has scaled my result. So let's go to, let's say, stress. You can go to any, right? You can go to displacement, strain, but in the first simulation I changed stress scale. Go to chart options, show maximum and minimum, select OK, and go to edit definition, and I need a true scale 1:1, select OK, and now it is fine. And here, as you can see, that maximum stress on this side and minimum stress on this side, right? It is similar to the first result, but it is not the same result, right? And lastly, I'll go to let's say create a new simulation, and this time it has already detected that I usually use this fixture, and right, in fact I have to apply this again, because I didn't use that. So let's say go to apply material, carbon steel, OK, and for fixtures, fixed geometry, this face, and this face, right? Select OK, and this time I'll apply torque on this portion only. That's why I have used split line command and I have divided my geometry, right? And just make sure to change this to 100 Newton meter, right? And select OK. Reference axis, right? So reference axis is this, and select OK. And lastly, I'll go to mesh and mesh and run. And now I'll go to, let's say, stress. I'll go to chart options, and maximum and minimum annotation, go to definition, and I need a true scale 1:1, select OK. You can have your user defined scale as well, let's say 20, 20 is to 1, 100 is to 1, but I need 1:1, and here it is also showing the similar simulation result to the first and second simulation, right? But it is not the same. We have done all simulations, and lastly I have to compare my results in the same window, right? So let's go to result options, इनफैक्ट लेट्स गो टू रिजल्ट्स एंड लेट्स गो टू कंपेयर रिजल्ट्स, राइट? इट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ऑप्शन दैट आई हैव फाउंड इन दिस सॉलिड वर्क सिमुलेशन. गो टू कंपेयर रिजल्ट्स, इट इज़ वेरी यूजफुल व्हेन यू आर हैविंग योर डिफरेंट सिमुलेशन स्टडीज. एंड ऑन दिस कंपेयर रिजल्ट्स ऑप्शन यू कैन कंपेयर योर डिफरेंट सिमुलेशंस, राइट? एंड जस्ट क्लिक दिस कंपेयर रिजल्ट्स एंड हेयर इट इज आस्किंग that current study, yes, current study, and I only need stress, right? So I'm unchecking this box, and in fact all studies in this configuration, because I have static 1, static 2 and static 3, right? So all studies, and unchecking this displacement option, and we have stress 1 from the first simulation, stress 2 from the second simulation, and stress 3 simulation in the second simulation, right? So select OK. Right. My SolidWorks has crashed. So as you can see from here, that SolidWorks has created a window, and it is showing some different simulations, some different results in the same window, and it has crashed, unfortunately. And but here you can see different results in the same window. So that's it for today's tutorial. I hope you like it, and if you have any queries, any questions related to this tutorial or any other tutorial, you can ask in comment section, and I hope you enjoyed, and you can subscribe to our channel for more tutorials.